Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Ah, man, it's been a while since I played this one. Let's give it a shot, I suppose. The controller mapping for this one was really weird, so I'm wondering if it's gonna be a problem in the end, so let's hope it isn't. Let's start at the hard difficulty. Wait, I don't usually spell until like that. Did they get it wrong, or am I getting it wrong? I'm gonna play...
Good rack.
The biplane for now. That's loud. I'm so sorry about that. I don't think the score has too much bearing on the gameplay. I just think it's strictly for score. I don't recall this game being too difficult. Not this version, anyway. Ah, dang it. Of course. On my tail. I remember there being speed pickups, too. Did I not? Ooh, a little ticey there. Man, the guy on the ground can shoot at me quite a long time, can't he? Ooh, close. It's kind of hard to tell when the boss is taking damage in this version, because there isn't any sprite flashing, and I wasn't paying attention there. All you see is like the little sparks from the attacks making contact, and that's really it. I'll just have to trust that I was doing damage there. I don't know for certain. I do love the environments they use in this game. They're quite charming. Also, this remake kind of gives a really nice, like, high-def upgrade to all the environments. Ooh, that was bad. I believe the gears on those things block bullets. Kinda gotta aim high on them. Shit. Oh, careful. Damn it. Spent too long at ground level. Got hit there for no good reason. I don't recall the boss here being tough, so it shouldn't be an issue. Where's the music? Music? If Let's see, where's the music? One down. Oh, it's the guns I had to aim for. See, that's another issue. Not being able to see the sprite splash when you shoot them is very difficult to tell when I'm actually doing damage. Made it without dying. Hooray. Kind of a long landing animation. Next mission, please. The Dark Mines of Raw. This one can be pretty tough because of the falling rocks. I'm gonna stick to the bike.
Good rock.
You know, music in this game isn't as great as I remember. Yeah, those ground targets don't go down very quickly, do they? Go down pretty slowly too. Man, a lot of the enemies in this world are kind of bulky for no good reason. Falling rocks here, if I remember. Yep. They're not as fast as they are on the Genesis version. I guess that's a relief, but still. I'll get these guys ASAP before they shoot me. I always look away just as they're firing at me. What's the deal with them? Why are these tiny ones so damn tough? Ah, damn it, I looked away again. Thank you. really do need weapon upgrades ASAP. Wait, did that one go off screen? Oh no. Fuck. I may lose a life just because I'm getting hit so much by those tiny guys. Why do they have so much health? Jesus. Gotta shoot out the struts on this thing. Kinda difficult to do so. Okay, high speed section, this one's kinda tough. I gotta be ready. Oh, fuck. I missed the health. It was right there. Into the scenery, I couldn't get it. I think I lost some of my EX meter. Yeah, I lost the 2 points I had towards the next level. That sucks. First death. But it was where I expected it to be, so that's not bad. Oh, I forgot, I lost track of which one I was. Shooting at. Fuck that. Nothing there left to shoot. This shouldn't be too difficult to handle. Oh, right. There's a point to one that hit the ground. Boy. I don't remember if this game has proper extend. True score. How was that noise? Something tells me this PC port isn't the best. I'm gonna stick to the biplane again. Okay, this stage is pretty easy. Music. what I picked up. Whoa. Shit. I flew right into that one, even though I was looking for it. Got level 5 shots, but it doesn't look any different. Be careful. Every direction is going to be open to attack. Oh, it's this guy. Hello. I saw you stage one. Yeah, I don't know where the soft points on that ship are. Hey, we got a bullet upgrade. Now it looks more strong. Even though I'm doing a marginal increase in damage. I can English, I swear I can. Not like it's my first language or anything. What? Whoa, 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 whoa. God, that thing aims immediately. Give me some space. Okay, I guess the red flashes indicate when I'm hitting something up and down. Well, where are you? Okay. hatches soon. Come on. Build a weakness. Hurry. Is this the one that doesn't shoot the lightning or the bombs? Come on. Whoa, okay. That was a new pattern. Or at least one I didn't remember. Okay, easy. I got to keep my power-ups this time. I don't know when the next time I'll get an actual bullet upgrade is. But every time I can finish a level without dying is fantastic. Beyond the Sea of the East. I think this game has like 7 stages to it if I'm not mistaken. Excuse me. Bombs, always good. Small targets are dying fast right now, which is great. It always bothers me when common enemies and shoot 'em ups take too much damage to kill. Feels kind of dumb, if you ask. Like, your small enemies need to just take, like, one or two hits to kill. Free for being absolutely, avant-garde. Otherwise, just don't make them that tough. Just put in a mini-boss. A larger enemy that's worthy of it. You know? I prefer to shoot down a couple of large enemies or a mini-boss like this, instead of having to deal with common enemies that take too much damage to take out. Where's he going? Ramming speed? Okay. I don't think shooting the balloon is doing much, but it is doing the red flag. By this thing. Sometimes it'll surface so quickly it just reaches up to get you. Must be near death if it's gonna keep maneuvering around like that. A little repetitive, aren't you? Second phase, here we go. Oops, that's my fault. I flew into that one on accident. Thinking hard mode, the difference between normal and hard is just boss health, enemy health. maybe bullet count, I don't know. As it stands right now, this is not too bad. Although I was getting a little overwhelmed in that middle section. I had to bomb sooner so I don't take hits. Oh, this stage... That is loud and obnoxious, please stop. Ah. Okay, so there's six, seven stages, I guess? Wait, no, there's that entire stage underground, too. So that's the sixth stage, and then the seventh stage is in the sky. Oh, jeez. Bombs are getting quite strong, actually. I wasn't expecting. I don't need the options, I have them. I wonder if that gets me extra score. Okay, we're at a level 11 shot now. Still no visual difference. I guess I'm throwing more bomblets. Yeah, I'm throwing 5 now, so that's cool. I remember those guys give you bonus bombs. I thought it was extra lives at first. I guess there are no speed pickups. This is just the speed you get by default. This is Battleship 2. I gotta destroy these fins ASAP. Oops, that was my bad. Electric? Alright, two volleys, that's fine. Where was the one that shot the electricity? Whoa! Yeah, I was about to say, there's no way it was just the one guy. Al, trashing stuff as usual. So destructive, sir. It's in my blood, Lucia. I gotta do it. Who else will do it if I don't? Oops. Oh, there's the lightning. Okay, this is the one. This is the weird thing that shoots propellers out of its cannons. I don't know why. I'm doing okay. It's been a slow day for me. Having some issues with the litter we're fostering right now, mostly because Mom is being overprotective against me. But hopefully I can convince her that I'm not dangerous soon. Now. I got 5 bombs here, so it's okay to do that. Please. Don't crowd me. Come on. Get it out of here already, thank you. Okay. Ah! I got crushed. That's fine. So this is the one I was worried about. With all the right one. When the lightning comes up, I'm gonna count. Is the lightning coming back up? I feel like it's going to, and I'm gonna regret being this aggressive, but here we go. Oh, there it is. Oh, fuck. Wasn't paying attention. Anyway, I'm doing good. How are you doing, Lucia? Hopefully today's been a good day. Oh god! Does it only turn on when I go in there? Oh, that's nasty. Okay, so we gotta really hit this thing in bursts. Busy day at work, so I'm rather tired. Just having a chill night tonight. That's good. Getting some time to relax. After work is a good thing. Yeah, this thing's still got plenty of health right now. Okay, I can't figure out the timing on these lightning. Oh god, oh god. That was rude. Okay, the lightning current just turns on at random, I guess? Can't tell. It's really eluding me. First. Okay. We lost one life, but that's fine. I lost one life, but I still got to keep my power-ups. I thought you were supposed to lose those on death. I just realized, unless you're doing Bible study late at night, now you're able to hang out more. It just now occurred to me, which is why you're here right now. Anyway, I keep on playing these shoot-em-ups because I like them a lot and I kind of want to play them more. But at the same time, I'm hoping to convince other people that, yeah, it's cool to play these games. Go for it. Friday night at sundown, whenever that hits. Oh, it's 9 where you are right now, isn't it? God, it must be bright until pretty late. Wait. Yeah, today is Friday. I was about to say, am I streaming on a Thursday? Am I going crazy here? And on days where I work, and I'm not spending the evening watching shows with husband. Fair enough. It's now 10 p.m., which means you're already done? Question mark? I can't tell, I don't know. Yes, I am done with Bible study. Oh, okay. And I'm here harassing you. You're not harassing me. You're always welcome. Ah, damn it. Oh, give me that. I want that. Oh, almost didn't get it. It was worth it. Don't care. Oh, man. I need more firepower. Ah, what? Come on. I just barely caught that guy squeaking out the top there, and you're gonna punish me for trying to go for him? Anyway, out of, blind curiosity, are you interested in these types of games, Lucio? Or am I the only one who plays this in my group? People say stuff like that all the time. What do I do to prove that I am a rebel? A bad influence that you don't want infecting your stream with my evilness. Evilness, my foot. I'm not opposed to these types of games, but I stink at them. You're only bad at a game until you start playing them, right? I'd have confidence that if more people played these games, they'd be able to get better at them. Which is kind of what I'm trying to do myself. Oh god, this guy again? Which is kind of why I'm playing these games to begin with, because I love them. But, like you say, I was terrible at them. But I'm doing the best I can to get better at them. Because I don't want to keep being bad at them. I want to be good. Because I love these games, and having them out of my repertoire seems kind of, you know, obnoxious. Ow. So I'm going to keep playing them until I can get better at them. But the trouble is finding one that I want to commit to. Because there's a lot of these games, as you may have already guessed, with the 30, 40 year history behind them. The trouble is finding one that you really jive with. The trick to getting better at these games is to find one that you like enough to keep playing, you know? Because when you find one that you love playing and you want to keep playing it, that is when you will have the drive to get better at them. Hence why I keep on surfing around different games looking for ones I like. Because I'm interested in finding the ones I like and getting better at them as a result. Know what I mean? Tell you what, once I start streaming, I'll do a shmup stream and you can help me learn. Ooh, yes. Choose whatever you like. I highly recommend some of the retro entries because they're much easier to pick up and play. I don't want you getting started on something like Danmaku Unlimited 3. That'll just poop bullets all over you and not even give you, not even buy you dinner afterwards. And I am Retro Llama, so would jive. Yeah, this game actually fits into the retro category, the Genesis game. Is really good. Although I'll say right now, I'm playing this game on hard mode, and it's not as hard as the Genesis game is on normal mode. So maybe the remakes might be more your speed because, you know, lower difficulty and all that, you know? I might have to play this game on the highest difficulty level to get it to feel more like the Genesis game, and even that's debatable. Wait, what? Did my bullets get weaker? I'm level 14 now, but my bullets got weaker. What the hell? That's not right. Do they just look weaker? They looked super strong a moment ago, now they're looking kind of bleh. Uh-oh. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I'd say this is one of the easier shoot-em-ups you can get out there. Bombs, more power. I will say that the fire sound effect in this game is not great. I don't remember it being this obnoxious in the original game or on the 3DS port. I don't want to risk it and lose my power-ups. But I was so tempted to bomb there just so I wouldn't have to expertly maneuver around anything. I'm trying to stock up bombs again because the final boss is the next stage. Oh wait, this might be a chance to build up stocks again? I got one extra bomb, so that was worth it. Oh jeez. Too many missiles. One of the more fun and challenging aspects of this game, though, is the fact that enemies can come from either direction, and you have the ability to shoot in both directions to compensate. Which kind of discourages you from hugging the back of the screen to defend yourself, to give yourself reaction time, because then you'll get sniped by people coming in from behind you. So it's always good to try and keep moving this game and hold center position when you can. This is one of those games that kind of feels unfair because of that, but really it's just trying to, oh god, teach you to take more offensive positioning for the sake of, you know, making sure all of your angles are covered. I forgot that guy had a flamethrower on ramming speed. If I could take out that last gun, I wouldn't have to worry about this. I'm gonna hold a high position here and then go low. Got that, now I gotta get that. Nice. Only thing left to worry about are missiles. Oh, never mind, he has another gun. Aye. Oh god, flamethrower. Please stop. Ramming speed? Hold high position, go low. There we go. Hey, I got an extend from that. Okay, they do give you points for extends. Extra lives, sorry. I just barely survived this stage, and now I'm going to the final stage. But that requires I put my plane into this bullet here. That's being loaded into this gigantic orbital cannon. And against all logic and physics, the detonation of the shell will send me into space! Yep, it's the moon! Because that's where the final boss is for some reason. And I'll stick to the biplane.
3, 2, 1, 0.
Oh, that's right. The shell they're firing is the final boss. Oh, what a twist. And you gotta fight this guy in flight in space. You would think a biplane would not be in space, but now we're a space shooter, buddy. So this can be a tough boss, just because he's got so much shit he can throw at you. And then the final phase takes some learning. I'm gonna try and disable some of these guns, if possible. Also, when it comes to playing these types of shooters, your first course of action for dodging bullets is to get around the pattern instead of trying to get through it. That's macro dodging in comparison to micro dodging, which if you were to micro dodge, that would be the act of getting in between the bullets as they're coming at you. It allows you to get more aggressive positioning and do damage faster, but at the same time, micro dodging is exponentially more risky. So for the safety, for the sheer goal of being safe, you want to macro dodge around patterns. That way you don't get blown up too easily. That being said, I'm getting a little too sticky in my positions, and I'm not trying to actually get to safety fast enough, and that's getting me hit. Okay, phase one, done. Detach the back, and then we're going to phase two. Oh, no, phase two is just color change. Got it. Also, it's best to try and stay away from corners if you can. Corners are your enemy unless you know how to manipulate your enemy's bullets to go past you or allow you an opening to get past. This underside gun is giving me a lot of issues. I probably should try and take it out. Doing some micro dodging there, that's not advisable. But we got the underside gun. Let's see if we can get the front guns now. Ooh, either they don't get destroyed or they're just really, really tough. I was watching my option instead of myself, and so I ran into that bullet. It's kind of spooky music for just the final boss. I think the final phase is a different tune playing, but this one kind of makes me uncomfortable. Also, my bullets are looking strong, finally. Is a final phase that detaches the back end? I can't remember now. Wait, he went up left. He went to the upper right corner. But he ended up down and below me. Huh? Ah. I got lost in that pattern. I got hit by it anyway. That's not a safe spot, got it. They anticipated that, allowed him to shoot that direction too. I'm gonna drop a bomb here for safety. And do some tap dodging. Oh, that was close. I would have been hit there had that, had I not ended this phase and canceled out the bullets. Down he goes. We get one more stint of power-ups. Not what I was expecting. There we go. Level 20 bullets.
Oh, the boss is right there. I guess that means we win.
Yes, it is. Hey there, More Salty. How are you doing? Welcome to the stream. I've actually played this one on the 3DS and the Genesis already. I'm just kind of comparing the PC port now for posterity's sake. So far, it doesn't seem too different from the 3DS version. Except the button mapping nonsense is kind of weird. Also, I can't get pixel-perfect scaling, unfortunately, unless I play at a really small screen, which kind of sucks. I was about to say, I'm not done yet, am I? Good. Okay, now I gotta get under him. He'll force me out. Yeah, I remember the Genesis version of this game being a lot tougher. Ow. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Ah, come on, get off. Whoa. He's still active. Damn it. I got tapped on the way under. Well, the worst thing that could happen is that I'm colliding with one of these bombs as they're falling on me. Also, again, not having the sprite flashing is making it difficult to tell when I'm hitting this guy's weaknesses. And this guy's just kind of wandering towards me now. Okay, now final phase, right? No, not yet. I'm not remembering a lot of this. Oh, just barely outrunning those bullets. I was getting desperate. I nearly lost track of which one I was there for a moment. Okay, I want to get a safe transfer. I'm gonna bomb. I have plenty of them, actually. What am I doing? Oh, hello. I was not expecting that. What the hell? I don't know why those didn't hit me, but okay. Ooh, I got an extend. Now please tell me this is the final phase. Because this thing had like 6 phases now already, right? Not just me. Hello. Oh, right. Okay, those rocks are important. Keep an eye on them. Ah, I trapped myself. When is he gonna do it? Come on, I know you're gonna do it. Is only 50% health he does it? I don't recall. Are those bullets getting faster or is that just me? New bullet pattern, which means he's changing something. Come on. How much health does this guy have? Does difficulty level change boss health? I feel like I've been fighting some of these bosses for a very long time. He's gotta do it soon, right? Any day now. Anyway, thank you for dropping in, More Salty. Sorry, I'm a little distracted here. Hope you don't mind me. What's up, and how are you doing? Do you play a lot of shoot 'em ups? Because I like shoot 'em ups a lot, but I can't seem to find any ones that click with me. I've got like two shoot 'em ups that I love, and nothing else is quite right. I play 90% shmups. Maybe I might be good at these games if I play that much. Done around 200 in credits. Oh, dang, nice. I've gotten like 3 games, 1 CC. That's it. Well, maybe there's a couple more. Because I did the Genesis version of this game on normal mode. And do extra lives in this game count as continuing? Because if that's so, I've definitely 1cc'd this game on multiple difficulties. The ones I love, Thunder Force 3, Thunder Force 4, Thunder Force 5. Okay, here it is, finally, right? No. Really? Come on. Someday, right? Maybe? When is he doing it? Someday? Oh god. When? I gave her one a heads up about the rocks. When are the rocks gonna be important? I know they're important. God damn it. Okay, I've lost 2 lives on this boss so far, regrettable. It's a really sloppy bullet whip, but I've seen them before. Oh yeah, some other shoot-em-ups I really like, but I'm no good at. I've been really enjoying Gun Vein. Oh, there it is, finally. Does a couple of these, and then, ow. Oh right, these things kind of like lightly home in too, if I'm not mistaken. Okay, what? Is this another phase? Ah, shit. Ever tried Darius Gaiden? Yes! I am not particularly fond of it. I don't find the power-ups particularly interesting. And I can't figure out how to do the enemy capture thing too well. The music's good, though. Ah, shit. I'm gonna have to start using these bombs, because I'm getting kind of walloped here. What is he? I should have bombed. That was my bad. 3 lives lost now. Is this it? Yeah, this is it. Okay, so finally he does the big fire wave, but you need to sit behind these rocks to dodge. Oh, only the body is... Oh, shit. Gonna be tight. Get out of there. Yeah, Darius Gaiden is really cool, but I'm not that into it because the power-ups feel kind of dull. Like, you're just upgrading your shot by picking up more power-ups. There's not too much variation to it. And you just dodge everything. I don't know. The theming is really cool because the whole marine life nonsense going on is awesome. Music's great, but I don't know. At a point, I just get tired of playing it and I just let myself get through it. Oh god. Ah, shit. Is that it? We're done finally? Zero Ranger, that's the one that got me. Oh, I love Zero Ranger. I actually got everything in that game. I haven't 1cc'd it yet, though, but the farthest I've gone is Loop 2 Stage 5. Loop 2 Stage 5 is my limit for that game on one credit. But that's a fantastic game. I love that game. I did finish it on stream, if I remember correctly. Oh, no continue bonus. Hooray! Wait, that's a lot of points for just no continues. Holy shit. Wait, that seems like a really low number for a total score, doesn't it? Huh? What's going on? That's 2 million for no continues. But I've only got 572,000. What? All stage clear bonus is 50,000? 500,000? What's going on? I should have 3 million right now. Okay, what is this score total bullshit? My score should have been 3 million, shouldn't it have been? What? Anyway, the hard mode in this game seems pretty much identical to the hard mode on 3DS port, which probably means that the difficult mode is going to be identical to the difficult mode on the 3DS port as well. Math not mathing. Indeed, I can math, and I'm terrible at it. Yeah, Zero Range is a fantastic game. Love that game. Wish I was good enough to 1cc it, but it's so fucking hard. I've come so close, I swear, but that final boss, and the big thing that kind of ruins Zero Ranger from being like my favorite shooter is, though, but the one thing that ruins Zero Ranger from being my favorite shooter, personally, is the fact that you can't see the TFB without sacrificing your save file, and then you're forced to play through the entire game all over again, and get all your credits back, and get all your stuff, and it's like, wow, that's really cruel. It shouldn't be that ridiculous. But I guess that's more incentive to get better at the game, and I think that was strictly the reason why I was able to get good enough to get to stage 2-5 without continuing. I'm still mad at it, though, because I wanted to beat the entire game. Every single time I got to the TFB, I wanted to just beat the game. It's like, no, you can't even continue, fuck you. It felt kind of dirty, like I was playing, what was it, when I was a kid? Aero Fighters 2, getting to the final stage and not being allowed to continue because checkpoints are suddenly put in and there's no checkpoints in the final stage for some reason? That's fucking mean. And for the majority of Aero Fighters 2, you get to just respawn in place. But final stage? Nah, you gotta use your credit to go back to the beginning of the level every single time you die, because of course you do. I'm mad about that still, by the way. Little Albert is gonna be eternally seething because of that stupid change in the rule. I think Aero Fighters 2 is called Sonic Wings 2 in Japan. I don't know what names people are more used to, but yeah, I like Aero Fighters 2, I just hate that stupid rule change at the end. We couldn't tell? Nah, really? Aero Fighters 2 is a dick. Stage 1. Stage 3. What? What's with all these achievements that suddenly appeared? Okay, so I got 5 achievements for clearing the first 5 stages. I got 7 achievements for clearing the 7 stages. I got 8 achievements for beating the true final boss. Okay. Oh, I was supposed to press buttons. My bad. Okay, now I got my 3 million. I was gonna be mad. I was like, why didn't I get my 3 million? What's going on? Yep, now I got difficult mode unlocked because I beat hard mode. I'm kind of annoyed that they didn't just let me go straight to difficult mode. I don't know if I want to play a Zep on this one, and I didn't even mean to do this. That is not B button, that is... what? Okay, this thing has some really fucky things going on with my controls. Let me show you to demonstrate. Alright, let's go to the button config. Sorry, I have my right shot set to B, my left shot set to X, and Y is Super Bomb. So that would look really weird on an Xbox controller, would it not? B, X, and Y? Why am I not using A? Well, let's use A now. Let's press A for left shot. Let's press A to use left shot. Let's press A to use left shot. Huh. It seems that every time I press A, it sets X. Why is that? I don't know. Let's press it a couple more times. No, it's not changing anything. What if I turned on my turbo feature and held A? Nothing. Hey, Dark Soul, welcome back. If you try pressing X, same result. It sets it to X. In fact, I can press X to set X anywhere I want. But A? Nah. I don't know why they do this. But it's causing me issues in some places in the menus. And I'm kind of annoyed by that. Anyway. I think this game is pretty much identical to the 3DS port, so... yeah, it's whatever. It's a good game. It's fun, but... what's this? Clear the game with a difficulty very hard. You mean difficult? Because there is no very hard. Wait, I can get all the achievements just for beating very hard. Okay, I'll do that another time. Well, rude. Alright, anyway. There's another game I was really interested in. And this one is... oh, I love Eschatos. I'm terrible at it, but I love Eschatos. Thank you for mentioning Eschatos. Here, let me pull it up, because I have been practicing, but I'm not great at it. You know, as to be expected. This game really gets me mad sometimes, though. Eschatos is a fantastic game. It's probably my favorite shooter from Cute. Eschatos. That being said, I wish Natsuki Chronicles was better, because that game just kind of annoys me. And also, Ginga Force I wish was better, but the weapon system in that game annoys my ass as well. Is the volume good? And we could turn it up a little bit. This game has fantastic music. And it'd be a shame if nobody could hear it. Yeah, I don't know. Ginga Force, I hate how the weapon system in that game works, and I hate having to do story mode in Natsuki Chronicles, and the arcade mode in Natsuki Chronicles is fine. Although the bullet trail thing is kind of annoying. I don't think you can turn it off in arcade mode. Doing okay. This has been a long week, but today has been a nice, easy day. We got to take it easy and just chill and not get too bothered by anything. Really? It got past me already? I hate when that happens. Things like that cause me to do quick restarts. But I'm going to try and avoid it today because I just want to play the game. I don't know what it is. There we go. I love this game, love the music. Such a great game. It's so cool in theming. You don't normally get a lot of shoot-em-ups where you're literally shooting saucers. Nah, I mean? Wish I was better at this game, though. It's tough. I've got this first stage pretty well practiced, but at the same time... I'm not good at the rest of the game. Got to chill and not be bothered by anything. Yeah, exactly. I set myself up for that one. Got it. That's tough to do, lining up those bombs for that. I don't think the Wonder Witch is there this time. Oh, wait, there she is. Yes! Oh, I missed that grouping, man. Ah, I lost one. Nothing? Really? Okay, we made it. Witches are always, witches are always there. Some of them have randomized horizontal spawn, though. Oh, really? I guess, that explains why I never see them sometimes. Or sometimes I don't see them. Hey, that's the best stage one I've had in quite a long time, actually. Oh, I'm so sad. Okay, off-center and then spread, I think? Mm-hmm. Ah, that was bad positioning. I can't help with the deviated spawns here if I want to keep everything dead. Ah, damn it! I cornered myself and then died for it. It shot one wave of bullets in such a way that I couldn't dodge it. Or I was getting trapped in by it. Oh, Jesus. Ah, fuck it, I'm not getting that. Love the music in this game. It's fantastic. Actually, the biggest reason why I picked up Ginga Force and Natsuki Chronicles is because more music by Yosuke Yasui. Oh, I don't normally hit this side first. Okay, it didn't mess up the pattern at all anyway. Well, I think I'm fine. I keep missing, like, stray missiles like that. Such great music. I actually do have the soundtrack to this game on an MP3 player that I take with me whenever I go out. So I'm always listening to some soundtrack from some game. Especially shoot 'em ups, because I love shoot 'em up soundtracks. Well, rather, I'm kind of picky about that too, but I have some great shoot 'em up soundtracks on my MP3 player regardless. Oh, I didn't get them all, damn it. Please shoot straight down, thank you. Oh no! Man, I keep dying in weird places, and I don't like it. Got him. Okay, stage three. I don't remember what happens here at the beginning. I'm gonna hold spread. Oh no, it's these guys, right. Don't mess up, Al. We'll be fine. I love this tune so much. It's so good. It's not my favorite tune in the game, but it's pretty damn good. Oh god, I wasn't ready for this pattern. Shit. Aw, man. I lost another life for no good reason. Give me the Wonder Witch. Thank you. Okay, we're good, we're good, we're good. Oh, fuck. That was bad. Oh, I shouldn't have used that so early. Goddamn 20-sided dice are just gonna harass me now. Oh god. Oh, get him out of here. Get him out of here. Ugh. Gotta dodge the space dildos too. This part's not so bad. I say shortly before I get killed by a collision. I also call these. Oh, what? That can collide with you? Are you kidding? When does that ever happen? Oh, I'm so annoyed by that. Yeah, I do call them space dildos. I've never been hit by that before. Oh, man. Incoming. Wait. Oh, I did it at the wrong time. Wait, no, I still made it. Oh, thank you. Man, I'm gonna die to this boss. I'm gonna be so annoyed. Because I don't normally die to this boss. I stopped paying attention as soon as I said that. Fuck. Joke's on me, I killed myself. And I did that to myself too, fine. The thing is, I'm so prone to making careless mistakes all the time. This game requires... Mind? That was my fault. I can't blame the game for that one, but I feel like a lot of the times this game is... It requires way more memorization than my brain can handle. It's not even that long of a game, so I'm not bad at the length of it. I'm just bad at it. Is it awful that I was on a different screen but heard space dildos and clicked back right away? Asking for a friend, yeah. You're totally wrong for doing that, Lucia. How dare you not trust me? You can collide with those pods and get killed. I gotta remember that. Damn it! Ah! And we're getting to my favorite part of the song, too, and I messed up. I almost had that. I practiced this part so much, and I still can't get that. Ah, how'd I miss them? Fuck off. I don't feel like dodging anymore. I'm so bad at this. Oh god. I wasn't ready. Ah, come on, directly with me? All right, those guys can turn, I forgot. And Mercy Invincibility isn't long enough for me to abuse that. This Ketsui and Battle Traverse are my most played so far. I've heard of Ketsui. It's another one of those cave games, right? Battle Traverse I've never heard of. I've played a few cave games, but I just don't get them. Everyone and their mother tells me, oh, cave games are the fucking best shooters ever. Now I'm not even focusing. Are the best shooters ever made? And I'm like, they're fine. But I don't think I have the kind of knowledge, expertise, or experience to really understand why they're good. Because I play them and like, yeah, they're cool, but whatever. Like, none of them are, like, interesting enough for me. I've played... The most interesting one I've seen, actually, is Mushihime-sama. But that one isn't that fun. I mean, it's got everything it needs to be fun, as far as I'm concerned, but... It's got a cool setting, it's got the music's probably the worst part of it. But the game seems fine, I just don't... Care? I don't know. Maybe if there was a sequel or something, I'd play it, but I've not seen it yet. Fuck, I'm so focused on killing that goddamn saucer that I'm not even focusing on defending myself. Mushifutari? Wait, Mushihime-sama Futari? Is that actually a sequel? Ugh. I guess it sucks to not read Japanese because I couldn't even tell. Oh, fucking come on. Dude, I was able to do this invader section pretty handily at one point, but I haven't been able to get it ever since. I don't know why. All the modes in both of them play quite differently. Like, maybe the music in Mushihime Futari is actually really good, but I've never played it. do I not suck at this game? I try so hard and it isn't enough. This is the weird section. Okay, I made it. Okay, I didn't die, thank goodness. My favorites of theirs are Ketsui, Dangan, Iberon, and Ibarra. I've heard of Ketsui. I don't know what those other two games are. All I've played are like Donpachi, Dodonpachi, Amushi Hime, what was the name of that one with the psychics? I can't remember it. Ah, shit. It had an interesting name, because you read it in such a strange way. Esperate. And the first one, I can't remember what that one's called. Are there any ports for Mushihime Futari on PC? Ibarra is very similar to Garega. Garega? You mean like the one with the invisible bullets? Battle Garega, that was it. Battle Garega is obnoxious. I play that game and it feels like it's always shitting on you no matter what you do. Especially when you can't even see the bullets coming at you. That's the one thing that really gets on my nerves when I play a shoot-em-up, is playing it a shoot-em-up where the bullets are nigh invisible because the bullet visibility wasn't put into consideration or some shit. Because there are some games out there with shitty bullet visibility and I hate it. Every time I see a game that has shitty bullet visibility, I'm like, well, I don't want to play this anymore. There. Why am I doing so well in the final stage suddenly? What's going on? Well, this isn't the final stage, rather. It's the penultimate stage. Never mind. I jinxed myself by saying anything. Ooh. You know what? That's safer. I'll just do that. Thank you. Oh, so the larger enemies do take damage from that. Kara's convinced that they didn't get affected. Oh. Surprise. You need to know a few rules before playing that style of game, very esoteric games. Yeah, this is the big issue I have with most shoot 'em ups, is that the rules are never actually explained to you. Even if you have a home port of it with a manual, there are some things about the game you just never know about. And I don't get why they had to make it so secretive, so obfuscated. Fuck, there I go. I stopped paying attention at some point. And that was my fault. No, don't say that. I've done better. What enemy alt display? What does that mean?
Eskatos.
Enemy alt display? That's those green HUD markings. Oh. Okay, so that's for the bosses. Getting late for the old llama, so it's gonna head out. Thanks for the stream, have a good night. See you for movies tomorrow? You mean in a puppies thing? I guess I could try and make it for that, but I do have movies on my Sunday. So you could come for that too, eh? Alright, have a good one, Lucy, and thank you for dropping in. At the round table. Okay. I'm gonna give that one more shot because I feel like today is actually a good day for this. I had a phenomenal stage one last round. Maybe I can take it further. I think the big issue I have with most bullet hell shooters is that I don't understand them. I don't get it. I don't understand how you play them. Because the retro style shooters, it's like the bullets are shot at you, you dodge them, shoot back, kill everything. Easy. But then you get to bullet hell shooters and it's like it doesn't quite work that way anymore. I don't know. Like, sure, they're shooting a lot of bullets at you, but none of them are necessarily all coming at you. Like, they're meant to herd you into, like, bad situations so that you get caught eventually. But the question from me from that point is, how do I prevent that from happening? I don't know. Oh, did the bullet originate on me? That's probably why. Oh well, that was my fault. I got too aggressive. Ah, what? Keep dying. This is bad. It's fine. Just keep going. God, I can't even beat normal mode. Ugh. I left the stage with one life instead of three. That was dicey. I don't know why I got that close to the end with. Ah, of course one stray missile gets away every time, huh? Remember where I started dying last time, but I think I'll remember it when I actually get there. I was way too close. I don't know how I dodged that. I have this issue too, where whenever I'm dealing with a large volume of bullets, my eyes start gravitating towards my ship, when I know I should be keeping my eyes ahead of it. Because if I look at my ship all the time, I'm not going to see anything coming. It's a really hard habit to break. Ugh. Okay, maybe we can do it this time. No, my... I fucked up. I barely survived that up. How'd you escape that? Little bastard. Hey there, Woofie. Welcome back. Thanks for dropping in. Hope you have a good lurk, man. Oh, I nearly forgot these guys. Ooh, that was scary. No, the one bullet. Please come over here where I can shoot you. Fuck. Oh, I swear to God, it's just, I'm so prone to chain dying. I'm gonna get hit again by the stupid transition. Fuck. Every time, I swear. Don't get caught by that this time, Al. Alright. We didn't die at the beginning of the fight this time, so that's awesome. I'm doing better already. I still died during the fight, though, so that sucks. Okay. We have a couple credits left. Gonna hop on myself, best of luck. Alright, thanks, More Salty. Have a good one, dude, and thank you very much for dropping in. Sorry, I'm not too good at this. I'm still trying to figure out how Shmuppy works. And it's taking me a while to figure it out. Oh no. Oh, I mixed up the spawns. Oh no. Oh, I'm okay somehow. Oh, come on. Oh, I almost had them all. Damn it. Damn, I missed one. Just gotta build the fundamentals. Just gotta keep playing peace. Alright, you too, man. Take care. Thanks for dropping in. No! Damn it. Oh no. Oh, I wasn't ready. I was out of position. Shit. I keep getting caught like that too much. Fuck you. Ah, man. I'm chain dying so much. Huh. That guy didn't actually move a lot that time. Damn it, the moment I press the spread button, just, ah, whatever. What? I was shielding into that, was I not? I'm falling apart. Here comes invaders. Damn it, damn it. Son of a bitch. Nice of them to leave that gap there. I wasn't paying attention. Maybe I can get to the next stage. Yeah. Ugh. My reactions are so slow. I think I'm on my last credit right now. Not good. I make way too many mistakes. I need so much practice, but I'm not committed enough. I don't know how to do it. All I can do is do the same thing I've been doing. I feel like I'm still just reacting, and what little memory I can commit only helps me when I remember in time. Still wish I was better at this. It'd take a lot of time, and there are too many games to play. I want to try this game again. I usually play on arranged mode because it allows for twin stick shooting, but it's probably better to play it original style. One thing that kind of bugs me about this game though. Is the auto bomb. If you don't bomb in time to save your own ass, you lose all of them. And that's just really mean. Alright. I was about to say, is that guy not gonna die? Prominent bullet lips. This game has some fantastic music, though. I absolutely adore this. I believe with my bomb, now I activate the brake mode or whatever. This? How? Oh, fuck, I did get hit. I was gonna ask for a moment, like, how did I not get hit? Now I lost all my bombs, Jesus. I should have just bombed. That'd have been a safer thing to do. Three bombs and all of them are gone because I didn't bomb. But I thought, I didn't get hit. How? And I got hit. This is such a great track. Right into that bullet. Okay, I've got bombs. Remember to use them. I don't want to dodge that. Screw you. Couldn't see how the pattern was coming at me. Oh dear. The bullet is way strong, or the bomb is way stronger. Activate it manually. Oh god. I was getting a little overwhelmed there. I had to do it. I didn't know miss that one, unfortunately. That's okay. It was gonna happen eventually when I had no bombs in stock. Damn it, I got hit. Get me out of here. Ugh, I can't dodge, I keep getting trapped. Damn it, ugh. I need practice. Keep trying. Ow. Not being able to actively position this stuff without moving is kind of challenging. I don't know what hit me. Now I'm fully charged. When's a good time to use my burst, though? So the closer you get to your target, the more score items you get. Build the screen, do it. I should be able to clear stage one without getting hit. Otherwise, I shouldn't continue. Ooh, excuse me, where'd that come from? Thank you. kind of a janky aim adjustment there, but I'm glad I didn't get hit for it. I wish I could hit on a finer angle so I wouldn't have to keep having to, like, reposition just to hit those people. Couldn't see the way out of that one, so I had to drop that. Come on! Ow! I fucking hate that. I wish I could turn the auto bomb off. I would just rather take the death. It would teach me to be more proactive with them. Not again! Whatever. I haven't learned my lesson yet is the problem. I've been playing so many different games where bombs are important for survival, but because it's a limited resource, I'm always like, oh no, I don't want to use them. What if I need them later? Need to get out of that stupid mentality. How do I break it, though, is the problem. Just something I can't shake every time I play these types of games. When I was younger, I would be so over the moon about pressing the bomb button, like, oh yeah, I want to live. I'll just do all the bombs right now so I don't have to do any dodging, but I'm such a resource hog now. I don't understand what's wrong with me. Use the damn bomb. You have them for a reason. Just use it. Just use it. I think I kind of get half of the reason why I'm doing it now, though. It's because this game has a free bomb, technically. When you build up 1,000 meter, You can use a bomb to go into break mode, and that cancels bullets and gives you more damage. And then you can go even further beyond after that. To go even further beyond. Sound like a DBZ character. Okay. Oops, I activated a bomb too late. That's my bad. Behind me? Yeah. And the rest. In wrong order? There's more of them than I remembered, too. Get back to center. Oh. Okay, let me back in center. Range mode really does make this game way easier. Especially with the bullet canceling orb that comes out of your little rolling gun. Oh god, oh no! What the hell? Rude. Ah, damn. It was bound to happen eventually. No, I didn't. I'm so mad. I did not touch anything. I don't know what the hell I touched. Fuck. It's so awkward using this gun. Nope. Okay, I think that's enough. I'm done. Let's pull it early. Alright, anyway. I don't know if I'll ever find a shoot 'em up that I really click with other than, you know, Thunder Force. But I'm hoping someday I will find it. I don't know, maybe people need to recommend me shoot 'em ups. Because I have a terrible time picking them for myself, it seems. Alright, anyway. Who's live right now? Anyone live? No. Okay. Well, I'm going to let you guys go. Wait, actually. I'll send you guys to see Ruthie. You guys have a good night and take care of yourselves. I will talk to you later. Out.